And by the way, adding millions of years isn't the answer. For instance, the challenger might say, mosquitoes have evolved resistance to DDT in just 40 years. If that's not evolution happening before our eyes, what is? Most Christian responses focus on the amount of change. For instance, they will say, well, that's just variation within a kind, or the mosquito is still a mosquito.
Yeah, well, both those replies are true, but they're not completely adequate because they miss the main point. It's also rarely impressive to a challenger who thinks, well, give it a million years and imagine what sort of change will happen then.
The point is the direction of the change.
That's right.
If the sorts of changes that scientists see happening in living things, like the examples we mentioned today, continue for millions of years, those creatures will be extinct. They will not have evolved into something bigger or better or more robust. All groups of living things are getting worse over time, not better.
Yeah, that's right. So things like antibiotic resistance are not a gain of function, they are a loss of function. And of course, evolution needs genetic information to increase over time, and science doesn't support that.
On the other hand, the creation account in the Bible has the information for all living things appearing right at the start. Genetics and what we know about the information in living things supports the biblical account in this area. Mm-hmm. Genetic information or programming must have been there when living things began.
Yeah, that's right. Originally, the creation was described as very good by God. There was no sin, death, or disease. And the Bible also describes the current world as cursed. Once again, science confirms that, things are deteriorating, the creation groans. So we would expect to see genetic information getting corrupted. And science supports that. It happens all over the place, really.